Today we're going to show you how to use an artificial European skull mount. It's a reproduction from, I ordered it from Amazon, Mountain Mike's reproduction. And so I was going to use the original skull, but the dog got a hold of it and chewed it off, part of the nose and everything. So we went ahead and ordered this one. I was kind of skeptical, but we're going to try it. Hopefully it'll work. So I went ahead and cut off the antlers right at the base of the skull, as close as I could with a sawzall. And so what I'm going to do is drill some holes into the antlers, and there's a screw that goes right on the back side. Now if you are really picky about getting the exact spread and everything just the same as it was, you're going to want to get a lot of good measurements and try to put it right back in the same position that it was. But on this one, I'm just going to set it as close as I can, eyeball it and get it as close as I can. And then we did break, or this buck had broke off his antler, so I'm going to show you how I fix the antler as well after I'm done installing this European mount. I'm going to start by using a 5/32 bit here. I'm just going to test it a little bit and see if it's the right size, and if not, we'll get another one. So I'm going to have to hold this about as close as I can get it to what it should be. Drill my hole. This is where it gets a little hard, and you might want a helper. I'm going to try to drill this hole. And got to get this angle just right. And I think it's really critical to cut this right as even as you can so that it fits flat on the base of this reproduction. It looks like it should be pretty close. These screws are pretty long, so we have to be very careful that we don't drill it at an angle where it comes through the other side. After the hole started, I would take that off and just go at a hard angle. See if we got the right size bit there. All right, I got that screw in on that side, and I should still be able to make some adjustments. Okay. For the other side, it's going to be a little harder because I don't have the antlers. Going to test fit it. Got the screw in just a little bit, and I just want to test it a little bit to see if we're about on. That doesn't look too bad. I'm going to tell you, antlers are extremely hard bone. So if you don't have the right drill bit, you're going to struggle getting that screw in. But 5/32 seems to work just fine. It was a little tight, but I want it tight. So we're just going to line things up and tighten up that screw. Looks like we need to go up just a little bit on this antler. Alright, so I did read the instructions on the paper that came with the European skull, and it did say that you can cut these base pieces here. So instead of shimming, I think I'm going to just cut away a little bit at the top so that it anchors down and hopefully works that way. Now if I was really, if this was a really big buck and I wanted everything exactly the same, I'd be measuring from the tips of every hind and the inside spread, possibly even from the eye to the base of the antler base. So, but for this one, as long as we can get it fairly close, this was my son Marion's first buck, and yeah, it's gonna look really good on the wall, actually. We do have some gap filler here. I don't know, it doesn't look like very much. I want to see how that works. So now there's two screws that attach the front part of the European skull to the rest of the skull. And that just kind of fits right in there. And then there's pre-drilled holes for the screws to attach to the skull there. Alright. Now, you may want to consider gluing or epoxying that screw on there. But in this case, I'm not sure I'm going to do that. We could always super glue in the gap, the crack there, before we put the gap filler in there. There is a hanger on the back side of the skull to hang it on the wall. See how this gap filler works. Squeezes right out of the tube here and probably goes right into the base of the antler here. I'm a little nervous about doing this because I want it to look as real as possible. And a real buck doesn't have any gap filler at the base of its antler. So I'm going to put it on here. See if I can kind of sculpt it to match. Do is I'm going to cut these wires, drill the holes to fix the antler, and then I'm going to hot melt this in here. Seconds. And then after that hardens, we're going to use epoxy sculpt, white epoxy sculpt, and I'm going to fill in the crack to hide that where it broke, and then I'm also going to repair this brow tine with the epoxy sculpt, which we're going to try to make it look like the real thing so that you can't tell the difference. Get these antlers blended together. I use epoxy sculpt, which I buy off of Amazon, and I just make sure to get the white colored epoxy sculpt. Yeah, just white, because that's more of a antler sheath than the original grayish epoxy sculpt. So I just use a few tools, just something to kind of spread it on, and then something to, you know, wet it down and shape it to get all the details into shape. So I'm going to go ahead and get started. You just take a 50-50 ratio, real simple, kind of roll them into a ball and make sure you got equal parts A and B, and then what I do is I then roll them into a fish worm, and then I just go ahead and roll them together and kind of twist them up to start mixing them. And it always helps if you wet your fingers, making it less sticky. And you just start working it. You want to be really creative in getting it to match up with either side of the crack, so that you cannot tell that there's a splice here. This epoxy sculpt does really well in feathering out really nice. It feathers out to a seamless effect. Create some of these burls as they should be. And I like to use the end of a round paintbrush to do that. the main sculpting done. Actually, I just kind of got the shape of it. I still need to sculpt in a lot of these burls and stuff on the brow tine there, but I want to show you how I get my color to try to match the antler. So I just use regular dirt, and I just kind of start shading it from the white to a more tannish color. And you want to be careful. You almost have to kind of gauge it on when it's time to do it, because if it's still too sticky, it won't look right. Go very, very light on it. And if it's a darker area, just go a little bit darker. Just using plain dirt is about as accurate as anything you can use. You can use different paints and oil paints, and they work as well, but dirt just works out just fine. So I'm sure you got some of that. You don't have to buy that. All right, I want to get you a good view of what I have got here. So, as you can see, this site has a lot of lines running along the tine. So I tried to kind of recreate lines on the brow there. And then, a lot of burliness that can be created with just the basic tools that I have here. And then we're going to start start with my finger and just slightly put some dirt on the antler. You don't want it to be too sticky when you're putting the dirt on. And I think I'm almost at the very edge there of being a little bit too sticky yet. You don't want the dirt to really catch a lot. You just want it to slowly stain it. So I'm going very, very light at this point. And as you can see on a antler, it's the deeper parts are the darkest. Well, I'm excited to see what it looks like when it's all done. You know, this buck was broke off here and broke off there, and all it was on here was this little stump when my son shot it. And then my brother ended up finding the rest of the broke off part later in the year. And so here we are almost a year later, finally putting it together. This what you want? Which one you want? There we go. Just gotta keep working it. And then at some point you might want to start wetting your finger and just kind of trying to lighten up the high points. And keep working that dirt into the low spots. Back when I was doing taxidermy work, I remember I used to have some peat moss too, which is a darker dirt. So I'm gonna see if I can find me maybe a little bit of darker dirt for the very base of this. But as you can see, it's starting to kind of look like the rest of the antler a little bit more. I feel like we need some more detail. I think I kind of brushed it out from putting this dirt on here. I'll show you the finished result then, but this antler is a little bit more darker than this one. It's a little bit more brownish. So I'm going to try to see if I can't match this one to this one. So basically I'm just using dirt and water to rub on this one to kind of get it toned a little darker. All right, just wanted to show you the final results. I could have used a little bit darker dirt. See, if I can get it to focus there. There. But I think from a few feet away, you will never know that that was an artificial tine. And then I just darkened up this side just a tad to kind of match that side. So there we have it. And if you want to go ahead and try that, I would just use the same stuff I used and use your artistic touch and be creative and keep working it even after you got the dirt on with modeling tools to try to get the shape where you want it. All right. I didn't get real technical on the backside, but I think if I had a little bit darker dirt, I could make it look better.